Today in this lecture we are going to study the implementation and designing approaches of lexical analyzer. So first of all we will look at what are the implementation and designing approaches, and then we will study these approaches one by one in detail. So first of all we must see that the strategies for implementing a lexical analyzer. So a lexical analyzer can be designed in three ways. The first one is using a scanner generator tool like Lex or Flex. So basically Lex and Flex are actually the languages which are purely used for generating the scanner or things like that, like for compiler construction. The second thing is designing in high level language. You just pick up a high level language and design your lexical analyzer in it. And the third way is writing it in assembly language. So let's see what these things are, how these things are done. So scanner generator tools like Flex and Lex are used to produce a lexical analyzer. They are like, we consider them the tools which are mainly the language which is only meant for the lexical analyzer. So the specifications can be given using a regular expression which on compilation generates a scanner that is capable of identifying tokens. Now how this regular expression is used to scan to generate a scanner which is capable of identifying tokens, यानी आपके पास इसमें होता ये है कि हम लोग Lex को use करते हैं जो कि एक language है जिस जो specifically lexical analyzer को ही बनाने या design करने के लिए use की जाती है. उसमें जब आपने rules और regulations लिखने होते हैं तो उसमें हम rules और regulations किस चीज़ से लिखते हैं, हम उसमें regular expressions के through अपने rules देते हैं for tokens, के tokens को वो किस तरीके से एनालाइज करेगा या जज करेगा कि ये टोकन है और उसको रिकॉग्नाइज करेगा. सो वी आर हैविंग दिस फ्रॉम अवर प्रीवियस लेक्चर दैट व्हाट आर द पैटर्न्स वी स्टडीड इट इन अवर प्रीवियस लेक्चर. सो बेसिकली इट इज व्हाट वर द पैटर्न्स. It is a rule that describes a character that can be grouped into tokens and it is expressed as regular expressions. अब यहाँ पे ये एक्सप्रेस किया जाता है पैटर्न हमारे पास यूजिंग रेगुलर एक्सप्रेशन. इनपुट स्ट्रीम ऑफ करेक्टर्स आर मैच्ड विद द पैटर्न्स एंड टोकन्स आर आइडेंटिफाइड. दिस इज़ व्हाट वी स्टडीड इन अवर प्रीवियस लेक्चर. अब यहाँ पे मैंने आपको बताया था कि हम रूल्स या रेगुलेशंस जो होते हैं उनको हम रेगुलर एक्सप्रेशंस के तौर पे देते हैं. किस तरीके से, ये मैंने एक एग्जांपल दी थी. द एग्जांपल वाज कि हम अगर एक रूल बना रहे हैं आइडेंटिफायर के लिए कि आइडेंटिफायर क्या होना चाहिए, तो इट शुड स्टार्ट विद द लेटर फॉलोड बाय एनी नंबर ऑफ लेटर्स और डिजिट. अब इसका रेगुलर एक्सप्रेशन था ये A to Z एंड 0 to 9 एंड ऑल दैट स्टफ. सो दिस वॉज समथिंग आई एक्सप्लेन यू कि हम लेक्सिकल एनालाइजर में पैटर्न को डिफाइन कैसे करते हैं ये रेगुलर एक्सप्रेशन के थ्रू. तो यही सेम बात हमने Lex या Flex टूल में बताई कि उस टूल को जब हम यूज़ करते हुए अपने लेक्सिकल एनालाइजर को बनाते हैं, क्रिएट करते हैं, डिज़ाइन करते हैं, तो उस टाइम हमने जब ये बताना है कि आपके टोकन्स किस तरह के होंगे या लैंग्वेज कौन से रूल्स फॉलो करिए, कौन सा पैटर्न फॉलो करिए, तो वो पैटर्न हम बताएंगे किस तरीके से, हम वो रेगुलर एक्सप्रेशन के थ्रू बताएंगे. So the generator provides routines for reading and buffering the input, and this is easy to implement but least efficient. हमारे पास ये implement करना इतना मुश्किल नहीं होता. आपको regular expressions specially अगर आप किसी language के लिए generate कर रहे हैं तो इतना ज़्यादा मुश्किल नहीं है. You just learn it so easily and implementation is very easy, but this is not very efficient. But yes, it is very commonly used. So the second way was designing in high level language. So lexical analyzer can be designed in high level language, high level programming language like C or any other language. So what we do, input and buffering techniques provided by the language are used for lexical analyzer, but this approach is intermediate in terms of efficiency and yet it is difficult. If we compare it with the first approach like the scanner generator, this is a little tough than the scanner generator because you have to pick up a language and then you have to write all the stuff in that specific language. And this input and buffering things, you will learn it later on that what is buffering and what is input buffering techniques. Then we have third technique, that is writing in the assembly language. So writing a lexical analyzer in assembly language is the most efficient method. It can explicitly manage input and buffering, but this is a very complicated and complex approach to implement. Obviously, like writing down anything in the lower level language is always a tough thing, but we know that anything done in low level language is most efficient. ये बहुत common चीज़ है, हमें वैसे भी पता है कि जब भी हम कोई काम low level language में करते हैं तो वो ज़्यादा efficient होता है, लेकिन उसकी complexity की वजह से हम हमेशा high level languages को choose करते हैं और उनको हम priority देते हैं. So if we do the comparisons of these methods, if we see the easiness या ease अगर हम देखें तो generator is easier on second number high level languages and on third number assembly language. If we see the this is less complicated, this is intermediate complicated and this is more complicated. But if we talk about the efficiency, the efficiency wise assembly language is on the first number, high level language have intermediate efficiency and generator had the least efficiency. So ye hamare paas agar hum methods ka comparison kare, then we have certain steps in designing the lexical analyzer. Designing the lexical analyzer either by hand or automated tool mainly involves the two steps. Number one is describing the rules and number two is designing the recognizer. So what we do when we say describing the rules, actually rules for the tokens are described using regular expressions. This is a thing I explained earlier that whenever we want some rules ki usne uska kya pattern hai, kya rule hai, to usko hum kis tarah design karte hain, regular expressions se. And then we have designing the recognizer. So recognizer is designed for the rules, that is for the tokens. So designing recognizer corresponds to converting the regular expressions into the finite automata and the certain things like that. So this processing can be speed up if the regular expressions is represented using the DFA. Now you are well aware of the DFA and NFA and regular expressions and finite automata. So all these things are actually done in the lexical analyzer. So you have to recall whatever you have studied in the theory of automata to understand it on better terms. When we have, I mean, I don't want to repeat all the specific stuff about the regular expressions or finite automata or DFA, NFA, but yes, it is part of your like course that you should know, you should have the knowledge of these things. That is why the theory of automata is your prerequisite for your compiler construction. So later on, now we will discuss everything in detail, like everything will be discussed in detail, how the lexical analyzer is designed using lex tool and how the other things are done. So we're done with this lecture. Thank you so much. Please give your feedback.